Embattled Facebook founder Mark Zuckerberg has released his personal challenge for 2019. This year, he's hosting a series of public discussions about the future of technology in society. This is Zuckerberg's 10th year on setting public challenges for himself. They started simple. One year, he vowed to wear a tie every day. Another year, he wanted to eat only animals that he killed himself. Well, in 2017, he vowed to visit every state. And that announcement, of course, sparked speculation that he was planning a presidential run. Then came the Cambridge Analytica privacy scandal. Last year, his challenge was simple, fix Facebook, which even Zuckerberg admitted at the time would take more than a year. Bloomberg tech reporter Sarah Friar joins me now from San Francisco to talk more. Okay, Sarah, so when you kind of look at this evolution of Mark Zuckerberg's personal challenges from some of the kind of lighthearted, doesn't it look a bit like it's been a bit of an evolution as well for Facebook?
Right. Facebook has grown more powerful, and Zuckerberg is tailoring his challenges in a way that tried to fix something about his company. Of course, last year was to fix Facebook. He said that would take several years. This year, the challenge seems a little bit about taking the heat off of Facebook. If I look at it sort of cynically, he's saying that he wants to go out and talk about issues facing the technological industry as a whole. Technology and society, privacy, global issues. And I think what he's going to try to do is make this sound a little bit more theoretical, things that are facing the industry as a whole.
You know, Zuckerberg, you were talking sort of about, you know, he writes in this post a lot about what he's talking about and what he's discussing. But what's the actual fact? Like, what are the actual actions he's going to do to fix Facebook?
He has decided that he is going to look at a lot of different problems here. You've got privacy as a problem. You've got content moderation. He's generally promised a lot about how Facebook can improve in the coming years so that it doesn't have the scandals we've seen of 2017 and 2018. However, it's going to be very difficult for Facebook to follow on those promises because it is so large now. More than 2 billion people use Facebook around the world. The company has not put checks on developers for years of their use of the platform and data for users. So I think we're going to continue to see a little bit of a trickle of these stories that are holding Facebook accountable. Meanwhile, governments around the world are taking a look at the platform, and we expect some of those investigations to come to a head this year. Mm.
You know, is this more about Zuckerberg trying to sort of repair the relationship with Facebook and their image, especially amid calls that he needs to resign?
He wants to become somebody that can answer to critics and make them feel like he is doing something, like he's listening to them, like he can fix it. The thing is, Facebook has all of these very human problems that it's dealing with. People who are trying to manipulate elections on their platform, people who are trying to use it to spread hate speech and lies. And he has to decide how much Facebook should really be involved in making those decisions about what its users are dealing with and where Facebook's role should be in terms of creating those policies, or whether it should be the government's responsibility to decide where to draw those lines.
Now, Sarah, you have some reporting for Bloomberg about Samsung users who just are discovering that they can't, for whatever reason, delete Facebook from their phones. What did you learn?
So, for years, these companies, phone manufacturers, carriers around the world, have made deals with Facebook to have the app pre-installed on some Android phones, especially Samsung phones. And what users are finding now, as they're starting to get upset with Facebook over the many privacy scandals, data breaches, Russian manipulation, they're trying to delete Facebook on their phones and finding that they can't, and complaining about it really for the first time, because for the longest time, it just seemed like a natural thing to have Facebook on your phone and want to use it. Now people are getting spooked by the app. And on these Android devices, you can only disable the app. You cannot actually delete it. And that's a huge consumer issue because there is no way to find out easily online whether the phone you're buying has done this kind of a deal with Facebook before. So people are trying to figure out what to do about it. And there's really no way that they can solve these problems that are really business deals that Samsung and others have done behind the scenes with Facebook.
And you've even spoken to some people who say they're just going to switch phones so they can actually delete Facebook.
Right. Some people have told me they want to get iPhones. Some people have told me they want to find a way to root their Android phone, which is a very complicated technical procedure for a lot of regular users. Most people are just upset that they don't have the choice that you would expect to have, that when you get a phone, you should be able to delete apps on it. And now you kind of expect to have apps like the SMS app or the calendar app or the one that, you know, gives you the weather on your phone. You don't necessarily expect to have an app that is an entire social network that collects a lot of your data. Even though Facebook says that the disabled version of the application does not collect data, the company says those things, but users don't necessarily believe them right now, and there's not a lot of public discussion about really how it works.
Pre-installed apps, though, this isn't something new. We found a press release from 2011 announcing that T-Mobile's Sidekick 4G, which came with preloaded with Facebook and Twitter, that's been around. Is this just another case of public perception changing then rather than the actual technology changing?
Oh, these deals have gone on for a long time, and users were not really upset about having a preloaded Facebook on their phones until the revelation of the last couple of years on the extent to which it collects user data, the ways in which its app has been breached and data has been spilled out to third parties in ways that people don't understand. Zuckerberg this past year had to testify in front of a congressional audience about some of the ways that Facebook works. So people are starting to become more cognizant of their digital rights and trying to understand what they do and don't have control of. And the option to decide, you know, what they want to have on one of the most personal devices in their life that they carry around with them everywhere, they want to understand how that works and what to do about it if they want to get rid of it.
Digital rights, that's something we don't hear talked about very often. I want to thank you so much, Sarah, for joining us. Bloomberg Tech Reporter Sarah Fryer, thanks again.